In some schools, young boys dream of growing up and playing on their high school football team. In Oskaloosa, young boys grow up and dream of playing in the Unidome for the state championship of Iowa. For the 1996 Fighting Indians, the dream began in grade school when they were playing football in the schoolyards. It continued through the youth football league and onto junior high school as they were undefeated. All along the way, there were those who said they wouldn't be able to reach the top. They had too much too soon. They had matured early, and when the other teams caught up, they wouldn't be able to win the big one. It continued this year when they suffered a very disappointing loss at Sheraton. There were those who said, that's it, they're done now. But when the dust had settled, there they were standing alone at the top of 3A football in Iowa. They were a team that paid the price and took the prize, a District 6 championship and the 3A state championship. For all time, they will be the watermark that all teams at Oskaloosa are measured by. They will be the team that young boys grow up wanting to be like because they dared to dream big and they made the big dream come true. These are your football highlights, brought to you by Life's Magic Moments, edited by Jerry Staten.
You can always be number one. You can always be a winner. Even if you play the game for years, or you play like a beginner. Little league to grow. Football kicked, horseshoe.
we began the season on the road at Mount Pleasant, a team that would eventually qualify for the playoffs as the District 5 champions. The coaches were very concerned about this game because the Panthers had gotten a head start on the season by opening up against Harlan a week ahead of everyone else in the state. Our coaching staff knows how important it is to improve from game one to game two, and Mount Pleasant had played the defending state champions dead even for four quarters. At the time of the game, we didn't know it, but the game saw the District 6 champions playing the District 5 champions in a playoff-type game. Zavalstead and Blunt both had 100-yard nights behind really solid blocking by the offensive line, and the defense had four interceptions, with Zavalstead getting three and Garrett coming up with a big one to stop a late drive to turn the Mount Pleasant Panthers away from the goal line late in the game. This was a big early season win and clearly notified everyone that the Indians were back and in the hunt for a championship. The coaches were very proud of the mental toughness and tenacity we demonstrated in this football game.
Ha ha! everyday dude. I'm driving with my baby to get her in the mood. She's dialing through my radio and I'm ready to make my move. What she got in rock and roll and it really blew my groove. It was rocks out of the question. Sunday weekend, up all night.
Our home opener was against Davis County, and our players always play with an extra heartbeat on our field, but this year there was added incentive because we had seen Davis County in a summertime passing league game, and they tried to make it a full contact game with lots of mouthy comments thrown in. Our players didn't take too kindly to these kinds of things happening. On the opening kickoff, Nathaniel kicked off the ball, then proceeded to go down the field and smashed the receiver, separating him from the ball and his senses. Ortegren scooped up the ball, and we had points on the scoreboard in 9 seconds after kicking off to Davis County. We never looked back as we dismantled the Mustangs, scoring 64 points, and everyone got on the field except the sports staff, and they were upset at me that they didn't get to get in. A good lesson here was, don't taunt this version of Fighting Indians.
Yeah.
on the road again to Clark of Osceola and another team with upset on their minds. The game started out kind of ominous, with huge black clouds swirling overhead, low over the field, and Coach Fick furiously trying to tape the ankle so we could get out on the field, and we ran out into the field without our usual pregame preparation. As it was, the rain held off, but the Fighting Indians didn't, as we held off a very game Osceola team until the strength factor kicked in the fourth quarter. The Fighting Indians had put too many hours into the strength training, and Clark couldn't keep up the pace in the fourth quarter. Clark really had trouble trying to defend our outside running game all night long, and Flaherty hit Ortegren on a 45-yard touchdown pass to keep them off balance. The defensive line put great pressure on their quarterback, and the secondary picked off four passes, with Chad Garrett getting two of them. We came away from Osceola with a victory in a game that perhaps we took a little too lightly. But as we would go on to say, a W is a W.